started. Before our show is on the way, I would like you to be a little quieter, of course, if you could do that. Right. Because I do want to give recognition to several people. You will not see them in front of the stage, but they're very important for the running of a show. So here we're going to introduce the stage crew, and down here in front we have Chris Fox and Eric Anderson on audio. And we have an ex-Margate student at PB High who came at the last minute. I just asked if he would help us on. And Gordon Farmer. Gordon, please step to you there. Now you can't see them back there unless they shine the spotlights in each other. Guys, you want to shine the spotlights in each other? We have Tim Hall, Rick Anderson, and Mike McKay. Okay. And on curtain, where's Eric Weicker? Eric? Come on, Eric, don't be shy. That's good. There he is. Mike Redlingren. And on the top, Debbie Dustin and Tim Skinner. And in charge of costumes, Angel Alberta and Annie Gauthier. We want you to have a good time, but there is something each year we have to remind you about. First, this show is primarily for the parents of those who are performing here. We have let everyone else come who wants to come, but we do ask you when the act is on that you show respect, you listen, and give them encouragement, but we don't want any catcalling and yelling, and if we have to, we will stop the show. I'm telling you that right now. So, when the act is on, enjoy it, laugh where you have to laugh, but give them an encouragement in the right way. Here we have a great MC. Give a big welcome to the start of the show, Jeff Friedman.
I'm your MC, Jeff Friedman. Thank you for all coming. You know, it's kind of strange for me to be the MC because at our house, see, I'm the Icebox Man at our house. I'm Icebox Man. I answer the call when there's a need at the Icebox. Two very important responsibilities. The first one is keeping people from standing with the door to the refrigerator open for more than 25 minutes at a time. Doesn't that get you mad? Do you want to close that door, please? Do you want to close the door? You let in on the coldness I saved overnight. Come on, close that. You know, some guy just woke up in the morning, his hair is all messed up, and he's all tired, and he wants to inventory my refrigerator.
I think I'll have,
Here is $50 for down the Burger King. Will you guys? I'll spend more than that on just electricity alone. Close that door, will you? Hey, if you want to know what's in there, why don't you take a Polaroid picture and go away and the picture come back for what you want? Years ago, we didn't even have Polaroid cameras. We had to make an oil painting of other women. Well, I'll let it get you down. Because there's a bigger responsibility. And that is getting into the refrigerator and deciding which things need to be thrown away. Most people will not take that responsibility. Most people will just go and get what they want, leave everything else alone, and say, well, someone else wants that. Someone else will eat that. Meanwhile, the food is getting smaller and greener and smaller. And it's in fact stuck to the rack. So I got to go in there and decide when to throw things away. Chocolate pudding? Does anyone want this last chocolate pudding? I have just one chocolate pudding left. It's only been pulled away from the side of the dish about 3 inches all the way around. And there's a huge ball running through the center of the pudding. Actually, it's nothing but a ball of skin at this point. Does anyone want a bowl of fall pudding, chocolate pudding skin? I'm only going to throw it away. Do people do that with you? I'll offer you some food that if you didn't eat it, they're only going to throw it away. Well, doesn't that make you feel dandy? Here's something to eat, Brian. Hurry up, it's spoiling. So for you, Dad, eat quickly. That dream pot is moving. Here, Bob, eat this before I give it to Rover. Ever been looking through the refrigerator and come across an empty plate? Well, that starts me to wondering. Did something eat something else? Maybe the olive ate the tuna. Maybe that chicken isn't really dead yet. Actually, a picture of a mouse with gloves and a parka on, you know, just waiting for the lights to go up. But perhaps the worst thing that can happen is for you to reach into the refrigerator and come out with something that you cannot identify at all. You literally do not know what it is. Could be meat. Could be cake. Used it a time like that, all the love. Honey, is this good? Well, what is it? I don't know. I've never seen anything like it. It looks like meat cake. Well, smell it. It has absolutely no smell whatsoever. It's good. Put it back. Somebody is saving it. It'll turn up in something. That's what frightens me. That someone will consider the challenge and use it just because it's in there. It's a leftover. What a sad word that is, leftover. How would you like to be a leftover? Well, it wouldn't be bad if they were taking people out to be shot. I might even volunteer, but you know, leftovers make you feel good twice. Ever think about that? Leftovers give you two separate good feelings. When you first put them away, you feel really intelligent. I am saving food. But then, after a month, when hair is growing out of them, you throw them away, you feel really intelligent. I'm saving my life. When you make a sandwich at home, do you reach down past the first three or four pieces of bread to go down and get the good bread? It's kind of a self-preservation thing, you know. What you're really saying is, let my family eat the rotten bread. I'll take care of numero uno. And down you go into the loaf. Looking for the two that you want. A matching pair. Then you gotta be careful pulling them out so they don't tear. But when you get into the top, the other eight slices fall the other way. I don't straighten them out. I think, forget it. Then I think a burglar made a sandwich or something. It's not my job straightening out the bread. But you gotta tell me, who is it, please, that puts into the refrigerator the half-gallon containers of milk with only that much left in them? I got one of those every time. Hey, here's some milk. God, not enough to drink. Better put that back, huh? Thank you.
You're not. wants, so I'm sure are yellow.
Well, your teeth are purple, and they've got two yellow. 5, 3, 4 blueberries in them.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, guys, you good? Hey, I'm feeling great.
O'Grady, Shannon Tucker, Jules Lansbury, and Kim Rowley.
Yeah. Man A, what's your idea of romantic evening with a woman?
Well, you see, take her home, my pack. Turn on some soft music, dim lights, gets me in the mood, and then we start to
sounds good to me.
Okay.
Man B, what's a good meal?
Good meal.
Well, I like, you know, artichokes. You know, dip in peanut butter. No, dip peanut butter.
Dip peanut butter?
More junk?
More better?
No.
Hey, come on.
Hey, no, dip better. I don't like if you don't like dip.
Okay, I like dip, right?
Yeah, I like dip up.
Okay.
Okay, man C, what's a fun day with a girl?
Well, it all starts at the park. We take a girl to the park and then collect bugs, snails, etc. Then we bring them home and put them in our farms. Yeah.
Sounds interesting. Man D, what do you like to do?
What do you like to do in your spare time?
I'm in the narcotic department.
Really? You must save a lot of people from those drugs, don't you?
Yes, I tried to get them off the stick.
That's just great, but what else do you do?
Well, I like cruising down the boulevard, my Chevy with Chico and all my friends.
I have a picture of it right here, Walker.
Really?
There's my Jenny right there.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Look, looks a little banged up, though.
Well, what do you expect? Do you wanna?
Well.
Okay, I'm gonna ask one more question.
One more question.
Man C, what kind of music do you like to listen to?
Music do you like to listen to?
I like the Smurf sing-along.
No, I think I know the man I like the best.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, well, who is that man?
I think it's Man B.
Man B! Okay, so, first we're gonna bring out the man you missed, this Rick Smith.
You're missing out, chick.
Rick. Come on, Rick. Man C, Ernie. Come on, you didn't get picked up right like that. Okay, and Pedro.
Hello?
You didn't get picked.
Hello?
He's not
the lady, not the people move on.
Thank you. Burnett, Michelle Denzel, Robin Bronner, Piper Cutcliffe, Barbara Busby, Jenny New, and Sarah Robinson, the Preppies and the Vow.
Around the school, the preppies wear Bermudas. They button down the collars of their alligator shirts. Some awesome deep, for sure we'll call them airheads. Oh my god, we think they are total nerds. Total nerds, no nerds.
Set of golf clubs! All right, Jack, now what do you think about that, huh? Okay. Alright. Cindy, Johnny, you tell them about this golf club? It's a brand new set of open graphite with 4 woods and 9 irons.
Yeah.
Thank you, Cindy. Alright. Next up. Alright. Let me tell you how you play this game here. Alright. Baseball? Is that down? Right away?
Oh, I missed.
Well, Jack, hope you have better luck than I do, huh? Cindy?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh,
show it right now to a group of people without whom this show would not have been possible. I'll tell you, at the beginning of this year when we had the auditions, I really felt we would not have a show. And when these men got together with me, he says, no, the children are unprepared, but nevertheless, we'll get talent here and we've got enthusiasm. And they convinced me that they can make a go of it. They're listed in your program, and I want to give thanks to them now because they made it possible. And we had Mrs. Berta, Bobby Bryan, Jody Faye, Sally Fox, Carrie Hall, Penny Lanigan, Dan Raskin, and Bobby Up. And we had one man in the group this year, Mr. Dennis Fry. But of all people, this would have not been possible if we hadn't a great leader helping us along. And I want to give great thanks to Mrs. Sally Fox who pulled it all together. And at this point, Jeff is going to say a word on behalf of the students. Thank you very much indeed. And thank you all for coming. Good night, everyone.
I'd like to say all you and TV Land. This was a great concert. Thank you.
Tell me what to do. I never saw anything like it.
Did you fade in a lot and stuff?